So many of the patients, of course, are concerned what their prognosis is. Now, there are different ways to evaluate the prognosis of patients. The most important, of course, is the staging of disease. Obviously, if you have stage one disease, a very small tumor removed, your prognosis is excellent, and all patients basically are cured. But if the tumors get bigger or involve lymph nodes, the prognosis decreases. We are now using different treatment options to improve the outcome with adjuvant chemotherapy. For patients with metastatic disease, we are here facing a life-threatening cancer because we have active disease and choosing chemotherapy to prolong overall survival. Now, over the last 10 years, the overall survival has now surpassed 30 months, 2.5 years, which is unheard of. When we wouldn't treat, it would be maybe 6 or 8 months. And this goes along not only with the extent of overall survival, but also with better quality of life. Now, we are learning more and more. We know some clinical pathological criteria. So when we look under the microscope, we understand potentially what tumors are more aggressive. They're usually poorly differentiated. The more sites the tumor travel to is associated with poorer outcome. If you have traveled cancers to liver, lung, bone, or brain, obviously this is more challenging to treat, and the prognosis is not as good as when you have only liver or lung lesions. But we also now learn more and more about molecular markers. So we have a test which shows that when you test for a mutation in BRAF, this is associated with poor prognosis. So it's always difficult to talk about, okay, you have this mutation and the outcome is not good. But the good news is we have now drugs developed to really target this particular prognostic marker. So I think in the future, we will have more and more predictive markers to select the right treatments and prognostic markers to really understand better tailoring of chemotherapy using targets particularly specifically developed for this mutation, but also monitor these patients more carefully because we know these patients may metastasize early or to unusual places such as the brain. So I think with more and more technology entering our clinical practices, we will develop a very individual, personalized treatment plan as well as surveillance plan. So I think this will help all our patients. The more we know, the better we can help you.
For an interactive tool to learn more about your colon cancer and your personalized treatment options, go to mycoloncancercoach.org.